Alrighty, so we have a construction update today, and it may look small, but it's packed with a lot of information. So let's get it started off with, it looks like the remainder of the lift hill is finally here. So as you can see, they've arrived on their flatbeds. They are on Fox Construction flatbeds, so they will be shipped into the construction site, where I can now confirm they'll attach two together at a time and then lift them into place onto the structure. So to get to that first A-frame and then to the second A-frame, it's definitely two pieces connected together that will be lifted up and placed onto the A-frame supports. The lift hill will essentially go up in just a couple of days. It'll only take like 2-3 days to get that entire lift hill completed. So that's pretty good. I don't know if you noticed, but you can see Rutherford Construction is back on site and they are constructing rebar cages into footings. Or the rebar cages for the footings. So you'll see in just a second, massive land clearing is going on in the Timberwolf Forest. Unfortunately, a lot of people are like, are they going to remove the trees? Well, the answer is yes. Tree removal is going along nicely. As you can see, they've removed a lot of trees. Rutherford Construction will then go in and get those footings done. The footings take about 28 days to cure approximately. So from then they'll start, it'll be ready by the time Vertical Construction gets over there. The footings should be dried and cured in time for the support structure and the track pieces to be lifted into place. This coaster is moving along very quickly. It's very impressive. So it looked like they were just getting themselves organized today. Nothing going on. I did leave essentially around 2 p.m. So when I go to the park in person tomorrow, I'll be able to check on if they got anything done. But it looks like there'll be a lot to see tomorrow, which is actually exciting. I'm kind of excited to get that in-person shots. Other than that, not too much else going on. They moved the cranes around. Looked like they're getting themselves set up to start lifting the piece. You can actually see the lift structure down there. Now, what's interesting is you can, if you look closely, I know it's difficult. We're really high up in the air. We're really far away, too, super zoomed in. But they have the catwalks installed or about to be installed. So you can actually see the support structure on the lift hill installed that'll hold up the staircase that goes up on either end. If you look closely, you can see the green kind of supports hanging off of the or underneath the lift structure there. So there, that piece is already like ready to go on and be attached, and essentially it'll be done. So you can actually see that they have catwalks laid down to the side. They'll then bring in support beams as well and install those for the second A-frame. And it's impressive. I mean, when I'm driving up to Wonderland, I'm way up the road there on the highway. I'm talking about way farther north. I can see the crane. And the crane is just a bit taller than the actual height of the ride. It looks like it's at around 250 feet tall. So this coaster will be visible from quite a distance. In fact, I know people that have helped me out covering this project that live just across the street from Wonderland, and they can see that first A-frame, which is about only 100 feet tall, from their house. So this will be visible from a lot of aspects around the park. So that's really exciting too. It's definitely going to change the skyline of Wonderland, which is exactly what they need. I mean, Wonderland is surrounded by highways, houses, and very busy streets. So the more rides that go really high up and are above the skyline, the better. It's almost like free marketing without being free. Like, I get it, it's an investment, but it's free marketing from then on in. So every time someone drives down the highway, they see those really tall rides, that's free marketing. But other than that, not too much going on yet. It looks like they're definitely ready to go for Monday. They got the lift hill pieces attached and ready to go there. They have the other two lift hill pieces that are ready to be shipped in at any moment. You can see another flatbed truck there with green supports. And the land clearing is well on way. They only have a little tiny bit of the forest left. In fact, that might actually be done by the time we go tomorrow. So you can see the giant straight plot of land bulldozed and tree removed. There were a lot of trees there. Sad. I guess we can hold a funeral. No, I'm kidding. But yeah, nothing else. The park looks beautiful. I love the trees. I just love seeing it from this high up. I'm so excited. Again, I know I keep saying this to use the drone again. I've missed it. There's just something different between in-person updates and then also drone updates. They both have their own different benefits, and I just love this. And again, next week, we will be in the park for a hard hat behind-the-scenes tour. I think next week we'll be there twice for a behind-the-scenes tour. We'll be there for an ACE event on the weekend, and then we'll be there for an Amusement Insiders behind-the-scenes tour for you guys. The park was very generous to give you guys a behind the scenes tour of the construction site. So thanks again to everyone at the park that is allowing the channel to do that. I wasn't even under the impression they were already doing them. I thought they were going to be a little later. So I was very thankful to get that email and be invited to come. But yeah, super exciting. Next week is definitely going to be action packed. I'm super excited for everything next week. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this update. Hit that like button, subscribe down below, and share this video for others to watch. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a good one. Bye.